Hey guys, welcome back to another America Truck Simulator video. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you're all doing well today, by the way. And we're back at it with another episode of Stories from the Road. Today we're back in the 680 and we're running up north from Santa Maria up to San Rafael, pulling the water tanker. Pretty nice looking combo, another scenic run. So I think you guys will enjoy this as well. And if you guys want to catch me over on Twitch, link for my Twitch channel is down in the video description. Be sure to come over and say hi, hang out for a little bit. We always have a lot of fun. For now, we're going to cut on over to the gameplay, and we will catch you guys later. Goes. Pretty slick looking trailer, though. Clear the building back there. This is why we can't have nice things, guys. Why we can't have nice things. And I'll even get it stuck going that way. Well, maybe that's a situation where you could use the diff lock or something like that. All right. There's a gas station up here anyway. So I don't have a tank, so stop and top it off. Let's see. don't know if I ever stopped at one like this. It's kind of convenient. $198, can do. Let's see here. So what, cut across the 198 there? Always up for checking out new roads. Yeah, let's see what kind of trouble I get myself into now. Still need to get check out Oxnard. I went through it last night, but I didn't really stop or anything like that. Just kind of went around it more or less. I guess I don't need to downship that soon. You were saying there, Gary, that they had redone Oxnard. So I definitely want to check it out. Yeah, because weren't you saying the other day there that they had redone some of the ramps or something like that? There, crew set. Go. Only got one ticket so far, and I kind of want to keep it that way. Now, last year, I think I had like half a dozen speeding tickets. No bueno. got sketchy fast. Evasive maneuver achievement unlocked. Hey Martel, how you doing today? Thanks for stopping by and hanging out. Do appreciate it. They announce they start to expand up into the Pacific Northwest, I am going to be one happy little guy. You know, give me some Oregon, give me some Montana, be good to go. And get this car off my ass, that'd be great. Good grief. I get to feeling better, man. I know where I'm at. People have been passing it back and forth and stuff like that. Luckily, dodged it so far. And the weather here has just been freaking crazy. Like, I kid you not, Tuesday night, right? So I'm in the Midwest here in the U.S., okay? So right now, where I'm at, the temperature usually is supposed to be right around 35 for the high during the day. You know, it gets down to the 20s at night. Tuesday night, it's almost like 70 degrees, like at 11 o'clock at night. I mean, like crazy insane high. Well, we had some thunderstorms coming through the area. Some of the storms were actually producing tornadoes. Kind of got that a little fast, wasn't paying attention there. But, gosh dang it. But Tuesday night, you know, super severe thunderstorms. I mean, like insane thunderstorms. Producing tornadoes like up north of me. We're getting tornadoes about 2:30 in the morning. Some serious storms rolled through my area. I thought they were going to produce tornadoes because looking at the radar, there was definitely, you know, rotation and the storms and stuff like that. Fast forward to Wednesday morning and Wednesday night, and we had snow. I'm like, what? So like in less than 24 hours, we lost like, you know, 30, 40 degrees in temperature, and we were getting snow showers. So I'm like, And that's like the second time it's happened within a week, where one night we'd have thunderstorms, the next night we'd have snow. Okay, this is the 198. Yep. And I can see already what you're talking about, Gary. This is pretty awesome. This right here is the stuff I love in game, man. You know, some hills, some mountains, trees, green scenery. Heck yeah. That was crazy this morning. I went outside, it was like 22 degrees Fahrenheit. hasn't been that cold in like a month. And we've had just a crazy winter. Warm weather. I like the last week in February, it was like consistently in the 60s, you know, Fahrenheit, which is, you know, like I said, about 30 degrees normal than what it's supposed to be. Not complaining though, I'll take it. Yeah, I heard about that, Martell, and that's bad. You feel bad for those people. That's just crazy to go from a drought and all that stuff. To have massive flooding, and it's just crazy. Just a little bit. And little stretches of road like this are fun to drive on just because it breaks up the monotony of, you know, driving up and down the interstate. You got the scenery, roads are a lot curvier. Gotta be on your toes. What's going on, Semi Frank? How you doing today? Not much, man. We're just trucking up here, getting up into Northern California a little bit. Doing some tanker hauling. This is pretty awesome scenery. Yep, I am on 1.6. Now, my sister lives out there, and I think she was just a little bit north of it. So she ended up being okay. Yeah, I like the update. I do. And it's not a huge update, you know, in terms of content. But I think there's some nice little things in there that are gonna go a long way. You know, the liftable trailer axles. Just some of the things they've done with the physics. You know, you got the power, the normal, and the eco mode for the stock transmissions now. They've tweaked some of the sounds. Yeah, I was kind of hoping we get to New Mexico too, but I think we'll get it sooner than later. I don't think New Mexico is going to be too far behind 1.6. My opinion anyway, and I don't have any inside information or anything like that. It's just kind of my hunch, but I think we'll get it sooner than later. Kind of interested to see if they come back over to the States here at the end of the month. You know, because like I said earlier on stream, the Mid-American Truck Show is going on down in Louisville at the end of this month. And SES was down there at that last year, and then of course after that, everyone knows they went up to the Pacific Northwest, up to Washington State, at the Packard Test Facility for 3 days and checked some stuff out up there. So, and maybe some of the updates we're getting here in 1.6 are kind of a result that you know, we're finally getting to see from that, the updated sounds, some more realistic physics, things like that. You know, like I've said before, you know, they continue to do little things kind of here and there to really kind of make the game just a little bit more enjoyable, a little bit better, a little bit more realistic. And just to improve physics, they went back and, you know, cleaned up some of the some of the textures and stuff like that that look a lot better than they did when the game first launched. They got one team, I think, of about a little over, I think, anywhere from 20 to 24 people dedicated to working on just ATS, and then about the same amount of people working on Euro Truck Sim. So that's pretty awesome. That'd be nice if they had them split up, you know, one team working on the north, one team working on the west, and they could really start to kick some content out this year. Which, like we were talking on Wednesday stream, you know, really feel like they've kind of set the standard moving forward for the game. You know, when the rescale came out, there was a lot of changes, you know, to the highway structures and stuff like that. And like Gary was saying there earlier, you know, Oxnard really, I haven't checked it out yet, but Oxnard has some nice ramps now, and I think they really got this thing headed in the right direction. Well, you know, fortunately, they have a team big enough now they can focus on both, and they're looking to grow the team, you know, even more. I remember reading a recent blog post. They said when they started out with ATS, they had, like, maybe 8 people working on it. You know, now they almost tripled that last year to, you know, a little over 20 people. So to be able to do that, you know, year one for that game is awesome, and to be able to, you know, grow the team for Euro Truck Sim 2 is, you know, pretty awesome. Cap speeding a little bit there. So I'm doing 57 and he's passing me. He's doing probably at least a good 60. Turn my lights off. Plus, you go back and look at, you know, how the game was when it launched. The map was pretty small. You know, there were a lot of people, you know, pretty vocal about that. And just a few months into the game, you know, they kind of put everything on hold, went back and completely rescaled the map and made it right. And, you know, that's kind of a big deal, especially for a small developer, you know, like SES. They're just a small indie developer. So wish a lot more devs would kind of take that approach with their games, to kind of go back and quickly, you know, correct it and make it right, and, you know, just continue to improve it and kind of create a standard going forward. I had another game that I've not really played a lot of since it came out, but I've played a lot of the past titles, you know, the Battlefield series. I played a ton of Battlefield 3, played a ton of Battlefield 4, you know, even played some competitive, you know, BF3 and BF4. But I've only played maybe 12 hours of Battlefield 1 since it came out, just because they're, you know, it's kind of the same song and dance with as it was with Battlefield 4, is they're having to go back and, you know, kind of fix some stuff and tweak some stuff. The frustrating thing with that is it was all stuff that was fixed in Battlefield 4 through their CTE initiative. And here we are with Battlefield 1 going back and fixing a lot of the same things. So they kind of set a standard with BF4, but didn't follow through with it in Battlefield 1, at least not in my opinion. You know, SES, I think, has definitely set a standard with the rescale, and it looks like they're following through with that with future updates. So that's, you know, that's awesome. It gives me a lot of confidence, you know, in what they have in store, and a lot of excitement for what they have in store, you know, moving forward. I seen the Finding Bigfoot video from Jeff Faviano yesterday. My God, that was hilarious. That looks like it'd be a fun game to sit down and play with some friends. Oh, I'm actually already kind of a, well, I am part of a, you know, a virtual trucking company already. Sure, most of you guys may have heard of it. It's kind of an older VTC, but KTI, Kalata Transportation. I'm one of those rapscallions. technically I'm leased to them. You know, that's kind of how we do it, you know, in-game, if you will. You know, we're all owner-operators, just leased to KTI. Actually... let's see here. Wait, I can do it without crashing real quick. See, I got all my box there. I got leased to Collada, then my little fictional VTC that I created for my truck and everything. I remember, you know, when I first got into truck sims, you know, back when hauling was still a pretty big thing, you know, virtual trucking companies were, you know, pretty big. But now you don't see them nearly as much as you used to, kind of here and there. You know, pretty much now, you know, you have a lot of, you know, Facebook modding groups and things like that. Every once in a while, you'll see, you know, a KTI skin out there, kind of here and there. Actually, on my W900, I have a still just have the KTI logo on it. I don't have mine on there, and then I got a 579 that has a KTI company skin on it. I need to break that out again. I haven't used that thing in forever. But I mean, for the most part, pretty much everyone just kind of does their own thing, and those of us that are, you know, still playing the game. Don't do any flight sims. This is pretty much the only sim that I really do, is the truck sims. I got a couple racing games, but I never really play them. Like, I keep forgetting that I have it, but the crew, I have that. Picked it up for free last year when Ubisoft was doing their big celebration last year. Like, they had an anniversary or something, so like every month last year, I think it was every month, they were giving away a free game. I was, you know, pretty excited to pick it up. I've literally played it maybe like 10 minutes. This, I play some shooters kind of here and there. Like I said, you know, been a big fan of the Battlefield series for a long while. Played a crap ton of The Division. I think I got over like 600 hours in that. That's kind of been my game when I'm not doing this. I'm kind of excited for Ghost Recon Wildlands coming out Tuesday. That's going to be a lot of fun. I got like a huge back catalog of Steam games that I need to play. You know, The Witcher 3, I need to play through that all the way yet. You know, some of the Metal Gear Solid games, I need to play through those. You know, one of these days I'll go back and finish playing through, it's not a Steam game, but, Dragon's Age Inquisition. I'd like to stop back just a little bit from these. Way the AI truck's got more than enough room to get through. Plus, it seems like if you get a little bit too close, the AI will kind of stop and... I kind of kill my truck sometimes. Actually, I need to turn around anyway. Get back into that. So that's the only way to really get that thing in there. Looks like there's a service station up here that I should be able to get turned around in. Really don't want to do a U-turn out here on the highway, so... Because there's... Those little construction sites, there's pretty much one way in and one way out. And luckily there's no... equipment sitting in here, so... I never noticed that before. Got a little skate park over there, that's pretty cool. I don't know why that keeps doing that. That's in-game. That's not the stream lagging out like that. Guess I could take it on a 5-low. I don't know if it's because I got the GPU overclocked today, or a combination of the GPU and CPU being overclocked, but it just keeps, like, lag spikes or whatever like that. I know the game does it itself from time to time, but it seems like it's worse now since it's overclocked. Than FPSs. So now we can just pretty much pull up, back up, and bada bing, bada boom. Be good to go. On now, so traffic kind of gives me a little bit of breathing room. So pretty much just about pull right in through there and get this thing in there. Fairly easy. Much better, much better. There we go. Well, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up there. Kind of a quick stream today. Got a quick video to finish up for my YouTube channel. Link, all those links are on my Twitch page here. So be sure to check that out. It's just going to be a trailer review of the trailer we pulled a little bit. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for another American Truck Simulator video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. And be sure to check down the video description for a link to my Twitch channel. Stream over there a couple days a week, so be sure to check it out. Come over and say hi, hang out for a little bit. It's always a good time. But until the next video, stay safe out there. Take care, and we'll be seeing you.